أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد أفضل صلواتك بعدد معلوماتك وبارك وسلم وصل عليه وما تشاءون آية نمبر 30 سورة الدهر وَمَا تَشَاؤُونَ but you cannot will إِلَّا أَنْ يَشَاءَ اللَّهِ but only if Allah wills. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the previous ayah he said in هَذِهِ تَذْكِرَ regarding تَذْكِرَ the word تَذْكِرَ we said Mahmood Hussain is not here.
إِنَّ هَذِهِ تَذْكِرَ indeed this surah is تَذْكِرَ a reminder. إِنَّ هَذِهِ تَذْكِرَ indeed this surah is
an admonition.
إِنَّ هَذِهِ تَذْكِرَ indeed this surah is
sincere advice, yes.
إِنَّ هَذِهِ تَذْكِرَ indeed this surah is
a ticket to travel. Where? To Jannah. Yes, not to Las Vegas.
إِنَّ هَذِهِ تَذْكِرَ فَمَنْ شَاءَ اتَّخَذَ so whosoever wills اتَّخَذَ he should take إِلَى رَبِّي towards his Lord سَبِيلًا
a path or a way. So whosoever wants or wills he should take a way towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we cannot will but only if Allah will.
وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ but you cannot will إِلَّا يَشَاءَ اللَّهِ unless Allah wills.
So you should write one thing, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has certain attributes. Three of these attributes are related to the smooth running of this world. Number one, ibdaw. Number two, خلق and number three تدبير ابداع خلق and تدبير you should write the meaning of ابداع to invent or create something from no materials to create something from no materials. What material Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created the heaven from? No material available. What materials Allah has created the earth from? No materials. This is called ibda. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Holy Quran, Badi'u samawati wal arz. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did ibda of heaven and the earth. Now, a reservation comes into mind. How? We cannot make this small thing without materials. So how Allah created this big heaven and this widespread earth from no materials? So the answer to that reservation, إِذَا قَضَى أَمْرًا فَإِنَّمَا يَقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided something, He doesn't need materials. He said, kun be and that is. He says what? His whole material for a thing is be, be. And the moment he says be, so that is. So khalq is to create something from material. Our creation. But one is without material. The second one is from materials. As Allah says, khalaqal insana min salsalin kal fakhar. He created the human from clay. وَخَلَقَ الْجَانَّ مِنْ مَارِجٍ مِنْ نَارٍ and he created the jinn from flames. He created the jinn from flames. The demons from flames. So that's the material. Now the third thing is, professor is not here. Yes, so this is tadbeer. Tadbeer means that Allah has created this world and established a natural system therein. This is tadbir. That's why Allah is called mudabbir. Allah is called what? Mudabbir. Allah says, Amma yudabbiru samawati wal ardh. Who is behind the smooth running system of the heaven and the earth? Who is the mudabbir? فَسَيَقُولُونَ اللَّهِ. So Allah says, even the non-Muslims and the disbeliever will say that is Allah. You know what I'm saying? Got it? Or not it? So Allah has created this whole world in such a way that He has established such a natural law and rule there through which this whole world and the things therein are running smoothly. These are running smoothly. That is called tadbir. That's called tadbir. We do eat food. We eat bread, chicken, meat, rice, fish, fruits, vegetables. Yes? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created a quality there in all these things that it provides us with blood, with nutrition facts, with vitamins, with the needs and necessities of our bodies. Got it or not? Got it? And everybody needs a food or drink to a specific limit. To a specific limit. If more than that, it will cause him trouble. If less than that, so he will be having deficiencies. He will be having what? Deficiencies. Got it? Got it or not? Same is the case of water. Water is, when you drink it, your thirst has been quenched. Your thirst is gone. That's the quality. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, otherwise, if you will drink what? The gas you are putting in car, that's also a liquid. That's also what? A liquid. It will quench your thirst. It will increase your thirst. It will or not. Otherwise, that's liquid and coming out of the same ground. Coming out of the same earth. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put certain qualities in different creatures for the smooth running of this worldly system. That is called the tadbir of Allah. That's called what? The tadbir of Allah. And everything created for a specific reason, that thing has to fulfill that duty. Got it? To give you another example. Iron, when you will sharpen it and make it the shape of a knife, so that is to cut certain soft things. To cut what? Certain soft things, like the throat of a camel, the throat of a lamb, goat, chicken, or as the case may be. Got it? That is actually the tadbir of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what? The tadbir of Allah. So if you will have a knife, and you are trying to cut the meat with and it does not cut, you will become angry and throw it away. Where from you got it? This is not a knife. It's not a knife. You know what I mean? Because it does not have the quality. Shape is look like knife. Shape is look like knife, but you can say that's a decoration piece. That's what? That's a decoration piece. Brother Hussein brought me a decoration piece from Jordan. Yes, and that is of sword. Yes, that's what? A sword. But that sword, yes, you can hit someone with that sword like a stick, but you cannot cut with, because that's for decoration. Yes or not? Yes, that's for decoration. Our brother Naseem has so many decoration pieces in his room. Yes, he wants a koyak and cheloyak, but none of them is working for the purpose, because that's only a decoration piece. Yes, that's only a replica. That's only what? A replica. So it means nobody will accept that as a sword. Yes, he will accept that as a decoration piece. So it means that if something is the replica of knife, even made of iron, but it does not cut the meat, so you will throw it away, that this is not a knife. Because the tadbir of Allah in knife is to cut the meat, and it does not. You know what I'm saying? So that is general rules. That is what? General rules laid down by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His words and the things therein. But sometime, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He transformed for a specific reason, in a specific time, the very nature of the thing concerned. The very nature of the thing concerned. It is supposed to cut the throat of Ismail, but He couldn't. It was supposed to work. To cut the throat of Ismail in the hands of Ibrahim, but it couldn't. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala transformed the nature of that knife as far as the case of the cutting of the throat of Ismail was concerned. Otherwise, the same knife cut the throat of lamb. The same knife, yes, it cut the throat of lamb. And the throat of lamb is much more hard than the throat of a human. Yes, Ismail was there. Ibrahim was trying to his best to cut his throat and to slaughter him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَا وَتَلَّهُ لِلْجَبِينَ. And he put him on ground. Yes, and he was trying to slaughter him, but it was not working. وَلَا دَيْنَهُ أَيَّا إِبْرَاهِيمَ. So we call him, O Ibrahim, قَدْ صَدَّقْتَ الرُّؤْيَا. You have fulfilled your obligation. Your job is done. Your job is done. قَدْ صَدَّقْتَ الرُّؤْيَا. إِنَّا كَذَلِكَ نَجْزِ الْمُحْسِنِينَ وَفَدَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ سَلَامٌ عَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we ransomed him with the lamb sent from Jannah and from paradise. وَتَرَكْنَا عَلَيْهِ فِي الْآخِرِينَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, because of that sincerity, تَرَكْنَا عَلَيْهِ فِي الْآخِرِينَ. We left behind Ibrahim, for Ibrahim, that whenever his name is mentioned, so people will say, عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ سَلَامٌ عَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمَ. 5,000 years are gone. Yes, 5,500 years are gone when we mention the name of Ibrahim. So what we say? Sayyidina Ibrahim, alayhi salam. Because Allah said in Holy Quran, وَتَرَكْنَا عَلَيْهِ فِي الْآخِرِينَ سَلَامٌ عَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمَ. That whenever you are going to mention the name of Ibrahim, he was a man. Say, alayhi salam. Allah says, then you people have to say, alayhi salam. Because he was a sincere moment. Because that's very difficult to cut the throat of your only son. At that time, Ismail was the only child of Ibrahim. That's number one. And number two, Ibrahim at that time, he was 83 plus 13. Huh? 96. He was an old man of 96 years. Can you expect another child at that time? That's number two. And number three, Ismail, he was 13 years of age. A teenager. 18? Ajak. Means the father or the parents are looking towards a teenager. After 2-3 years, he will become 18 and he will get graduated from school and then he will earn and we will eat. Yes, that is the case. Now look into these 3 points only. But at that time when he saw in his dream that I have a knife in my hand and I was cutting the throat of Ismail, ya subhanallah, he never delayed it. He asked Ismail, إِنِّي أَرَى فِي الْمَنَامِ أَنِّي أَذْبَحُكَ فَانْظُرْ مَاذَا تَرَى. What's your opinion? This is my dream. And this is the dream of a messenger. That's not the dream of a common layman. It must be taken as is. Must be taken as is. So do you know what Ismail said? He was not a teenager living in America. They dead. Are you crazy? Should I call 911? Should I call 911? Child abuse. Yes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَانْظُرْ مَاذَا تَرَى. What he said? قَالَ يَا أَبَتِ فَعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرَ. Dad, do whatever you have been ordered and commanded by Allah. سَتَجِدُنِي إِنْشَاءَ اللَّهُ مِنَ الصَّابِرِينَ. If Allah wills, you will find me that I will never do even... Oof. Yes, I will never do. You will be cutting my throat. I will never say, oh, painful. Yes, you mean anesthesia. Painful. You mean what? Full anesthesia. No. I will never say, oh, ستجدني انشاء الله من الصابرين.
یہ فیضان نظر آیا کہ مکتب کی کرامتی سکھائے کس نے اسماعیل کو آداب فرزندی.
اسماعیل was a graduate of Oxford at that time or of a madrasa somewhere. No, he has never been in a madrasa for one day even. یہ فیضان نظر آیا, that obedience was not because of a madrasa. That was not because of an education institute. That was because of the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why living here in America, never depend upon the education you are providing your kids. Yes, depend upon who? Allah only. That, oh Allah, that what I can do. But things that is in your control. رَبَّنَا هَبْلَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَّاتِنَا قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنْ وَاجْعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ إِمَامًا. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our spouses and our kids the comforts to our eyes. The comfort to our eyes. Only Allah can do that. Otherwise, sometime you will see that one parent, they are taking a lot of care of their kids. But their kids, subhanallah, crazy. They are what? Giving them a tough time. Yes, they see them, the teenagers, they are in bar or something like that. They are busy in racing and things like that. They are busy and all dirty things and games and things like that. Oh, the parents, why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He doesn't will to make them good. And the parents, they never ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make them good. Because they depend upon them. I am taking a lot of care of my kids. Oh brother, don't be proud of what you are doing. Otherwise you will lose them. Yes, say, oh Allah, you can do it. We cannot. Yes, and there are certain parents, yes, they are not giving a little bit time to their kids, and their kids, with the grace of Allah, they are very much obedient. Yes, they are very much obedient and very committed Muslims, practical Muslims. So it means that it comes where from that's also the tadbeer of Allah. That's also what? The same thing, tadbeer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So anyhow, I was referring to tadbeer, that this is tadbeer, that certain things have been created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a specific result. As I mentioned, water to quench your thirst. Yes, or poison to kill a living entity. Poison for what? To kill a living entity. So sometime, a poison is a poison to that extent that it can kill any living entity. That's very strong poison. That's very strong. But in certain cases, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala transformed the nature for some specific person. It happened to Sayyidina Khalid ibn Walid radiallahu ta'ala an, when he was captured by the non-Muslim army in the battlefield. Yes, and they asked him that if you will drink this cup of poison, because you say that everything is in the control of Allah and Muhammad is the messenger of Allah and you are his follower and you are his companion. So if you will drink it and nothing will happen to you, so you will accept the message of Muhammad then. So Sayyidina Khalid ibn Walid radiallahu never thought for a while. Never thought for a while. He picked up the cup and he said, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. He said, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The only thing, Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu asked him, why you did it? Why you? Maybe some other people who do not have their strong iman in Allah, they will try the same and they are gone. They will try the same and they are gone. He said that actually that was the matter of, that was a challenge to the Prophet and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that's why I did it. That's why I did it. So Umar asked him, what happened to you? He said nothing. Only my forehead started sweating. My forehead started sweating. Yes, and I did it like this. And they were looking at each other. What's wrong with this guy? Nothing happened to him. Otherwise, this poison was supposed to kill him in 5 minutes. But he's okay. So many people, they accepted the message of Muhammad without wait al ashadu Allah ilaha illallah. What? That is called what? Talbi mahiya. Or transformation by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his own tadbeer. Yes? And in other words, we call it miracles. We call it what? Miracles. But write down that we as Muslim, we are bound of Sharia. We are not bound of miracles. So a Muslim, he may not wait for miracles. He must do something on his own. He is living in world of amal and actions. Where he is living? In world of deeds and actions. He has to do something. He should not wait for miracles. Miracles happens accidentally. Miracle happens accidentally. وَمَا كَانَ لِرَسُولٍ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ بِآيَةٍ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, even a messenger cannot show a miracle without the leave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Got it? Got it or not? Now, regarding every single issue in this world, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَتَبَ مَقَادِيرَ الْخَلَائِقِ قَبْلَ خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ بِخَمْسِينَ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put on record. He has put on record his decree regarding every single issue 50,000 years before the creation of this world. Yes, what is today's date? 327. This 327, Friday night. Time is 8:45. 8:45. This is a decree which has been written by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 50,000 years before the creation of this world, that Mr. So-and-so, on such and such day, such and such day, such and such time, he will be sitting here in Granada Hills, he will be studying the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say alhamdulillah. What a good decree Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written in your favor. Yes? So alhamdulillah. 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 Oh Allah, keep us committed with Quran and Sunnah until our last breath. Yes. This is the کہ سر ہو قدموں پہ تیرے اور قضا آ جائے ایسے انجام سے بہتر کوئی انجام نہیں. That's the ultimate good end of a person if he is connected to Quran and Sunnah and the death approaches him. Yes, and if somebody is sitting in casino and spinning the wheel, And at the same time, the angel of death approached him. So what do you think about such a guy? And nobody knows when he is going to die. So why he is going to such like places? If somebody is sitting in bar and red wine, he has the cup therein, and the angel of death approach him. Do you think that the angel of death will call him 5 minutes before that I am coming, and he will say, okay, Bismillah, astaghfirullah, oh Allah forgive me. He will never give him a call. He can approach him any time. Therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Never die but in form of Islam. Never die but in form of Islam. So nobody knows what time he is going to die. He must try 24/7 to be in form of Islam. Not in violation of Islam. Not in violation of the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Got it? So now regarding every single thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has his own decree. That's the tadbir of Allah. You should write it. Regarding every single thing, Allah has his own decision or his own will. So if the will of a person, the will or the planning of a person, it happened the same as will of Allah. It happened the same as will of Allah. So he will get into success. He will have it. Because his will is as the will of Allah is. Yes? And if the will of Allah is something else, and your will is something else, you plan to your best, to the best of your knowledge, to the best of your power, as much as you can do, you did it. But the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is other way around. That is, other way around. So what will happen? Can you overtake the will of Allah? No, his will overtake your will. Thing will happen not according to your desires. It will become according to the will of Allah. And that is the matter of taqdeer or the issue of destiny. That's what? Yes, that issue of destiny. There you have to believe in that what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decided. So that's why Allah said, you should try to your best to take this path towards Allah based upon the talimat and the instructions of Surah Ad-Dahr, because that's a ticket to travel towards Jannah. So you have to make your plan and to have your will in this regard. But Allah said, وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ. But you cannot make such a will, but only if Allah will the same. Got it? Not it? Or about it? Yes. Surah Al-Muddassir. Surah Al. This is true. Fear kalla mean is haqqan. This is true.
Kalla, this is true. Innahu tazkira, this holy Quran is.
What? The same tazkira.
Kalla innahu tazkira, this holy Quran is tazkira.
Sincere advice, admonition, reminder, a ticket.
Kalla innahu tazkira, this holy Quran is tazkira. That is a reminder, a sincere advice and admonition. Faman sha'a zakara, so whosoever will. So whosoever will zakara, he may receive an admonition from it.
Zakara. He may receive an admonition from it. But once again Allah says, whosoever wills to take an admonition here from. But again Allah said,
وَمَا يَذْكُرُونَ and they cannot receive an admonition here from إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ Allah, but only if Allah wills the same.
But only if Allah wills the same. So look, Allah willed you, he brought you here to masjid to study the book of Allah, to study the tafsir. Why you came here? Because Allah willed the same for you. You did make your intention. That's your will. That's your will. But your will became the same as the will of Allah in favor of you is. That's why you are here. Got it? Yeah. There will be certain people, they will be having their plan to come, but still the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not in their favor. Got it or not? Yes. And that's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever he performed any ibadah or any worship, he said, Alhamdulillah. Praise be to Allah who enabled me to do it. Praise be to Allah who enabled me.
कल्ला इल्लो तस्किरा फॉर श्योर दिस इज ए सिंसियर एडवाइस फॉर मन शाह जकरा सो हूसोएवर विल He may receive an admonition or sincere advice from this book. وَمَا يَذْكُرُونَ they cannot receive it. إِلَّا أَنْ يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ but only if Allah will the same. هُوَ أَهْلُ التَّقْوَى Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is أَهْلُ التَّقْوَى is the deserving one to be dutiful to him. He is the deserving one. أَهْلُ التَّقْوَى Taqwa is actually the practice of a human being. Taqwa is practice of whom? A human being. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I am the family of taqwa. Literal meaning of Ahlul Taqwa. I am the family. Means I am the deserving one for taqwa. That you should do taqwa for the sake of Allah. Huwa Ahlul Taqwa wa Ahlul Maghfira. And he is the one who forgives. He is the one who forgives. Surah At-Takwir. Take it from ayah number 19. To make the concept clear till the end of surah. Got it? إِنَّهُ لَقَوْلُ رَسُولِ الْكَرِيمِ Indeed, the Surah Quran is لَقَوْلُ رَسُولِ الْكَرِيمِ These are the words of رَسُولِ الْكَرِيمِ A most honorable messenger, Jibreel. A most honorable messenger, Jibreel. ذِي قُوَّةٍ The one who has power. He is not a weak messenger. He is not a weak man. As I told you, that try to be a strong one, not a weak one. When you speak, your speech must be a strong one. Don't give any access to shaitan and people who have satanic nature. Just stop him at the moment. Got it? When you are in battlefield, show your strength. When you have aqidah, have it a strong one. Have your character, a strong character. Your action, say, A strong action. Your business, show your strength therein. Your job, show your ability and capability there. Because Prophet ﷺ said, Al-Mu'min al-Qawiyyu khairun wa ahabbu ilallah min al-Mu'min al-Zaif. A strong mu'min is the best one. And he is the beloved of Allah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then a weak mu'min. But Rasulullah ﷺ says, still a weak mu'min is mu'min of kullin khair. Both are okay. As we say in American terms, yes, you are okay also. Yes, to take a stand. And if you cannot take a stand, how we can say that you are a strong man? Just take a stand. Oh, Zafar said, Ke jhoot bolaye to qaim bhi raho us pe Zafar. This for you, Brosh. Ke jhoot bolaye to qaim bhi raho us pe Zafar. Aadmi ko sahibe kirdar hona chahiye. Yes, when you took a stand, so stick to your guns. Be strict to your guns. That this is the ultimate word. That, no way. That's the end of the story. And if you were pressurized by people and, my brother, what are you doing? You are of nowhere. Yes, be a man or a woman and don't be the third one we were talking about. Yes, yesterday he spoke very bad about you. Yes, but you were not here. So let me tell you, so you may not get a reward and he should drop his sins. Because he was this. Yeah, so yesterday the topic was very interesting topic. In inheritance, it was very interesting topic. Yes, and the moment I started, they both were laughing. So I don't know why Nisar Ahmad was laughing. Yes, I didn't know. But why he was laughing, I was very much aware of. إِنَّهُ لَقَوْلُ رَسُولِ الْكَرِيمِ Indeed, these are the words of an honorable messenger of Allah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. زِيقُوتٍ the owner of power. عِنْدَ دِلْغَرْشِ مَكِينَ عِنْدَ دِلْغَرْشِ مَكِينَ And a person of high rank with the Lord of the throne. Yes. Lord of the throne is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A person of high rank means that he is sitting in the front of. He is sitting where? In the front of? Who? Jibreel. Zi quwwatin indadil gharshi makinil muta'in. And he is the one who has been obeyed by angels there. Muta'in samma amil and he is the trustworthy person.
he is not cheating in wahi he has received from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Muta'in thumma amin wa ma sahibukum bi majnun and your companion Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not a madman.
So the people of Makkah, they used to make objections about Jibreel. Number one, they were saying to each other, maybe someone, Satan is coming to Muhammad and he is thinking of him that that is angel. Look at there, how they were making things confused, or how they were trying to confuse people. How they were trying to what? To confuse people, because they had been inspired by Satan to say such like what, to confuse people about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So maybe some Satan is coming to him, but he says that he is an angel and that is Jibreel. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, not at all. They tell him, innahu la qawlu rasulin kareem. And he is the respectable messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then they were saying, yes, maybe he is angel, but we don't know that how powerful he is there in the court of Allah. So Allah said, zi quwwa. He is the powerful personality. He is what? The powerful personality. Yes. So sometimes you will be having power, but you do not have respect in the eyes of people. Yes. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, عند ذي العرش مكين. He has a lot of respect in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now Jibreel was cleared. Jibreel was cleared. So they say, but Muhammad, we think that he is a madman. He has some psycho problem. He has what? Some psycho problem, hallucination. Yes. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered that very objection as well.
وَمَا صَاحِبُكُمْ بِمَجْنُونَ and your companion Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not a madman.
He is not a madman.
وَمَا صَاحِبُكُمْ بِمَجْنُونَ.
Now their third objection was that maybe Jibreel is coming to him, but sometime Satan will be approaching him and he is getting confused that this is the same Jibreel, because sometime maybe he cannot recognize him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, how can you say that? Because he has seen Jibreel in his original shape. He has seen Jibreel in his original shape. So he will never get confused in recognition of Jibreel.
وَلَقَدْ رَآهُ بِالْأُفُقِ الْمُبِينِ. And indeed, he has seen him بِالْأُفُقِ الْمُبِينِ in the clear horizon. وَمَا هُوَ عَلَى الْغَيْبِ.
Oh, maybe he has seen Jibreel on the clear horizon. But regarding certain things, maybe Muhammad is telling lies. Maybe Muhammad is telling lies.
Because if you want to disconnect people from Allah, disconnect them from someone who is leading them towards Allah. So that was their case, that they were trying to disconnect people from Muhammad in one way or the other. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Now look, certain people, they are trying to disconnect people from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they do not say anything bad against Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They are attacking his sahaba. They are attacking what? His sahaba. If people got disconnected from sahaba, people got disconnected from sahaba, what will be the ultimate result? Disconnected from Rasulullah. And someone who is disconnected from Rasulullah, what will be the ultimate result? Disconnected from Allah. You know what I'm saying? Someone who is teaching you tafsir or hadith or deen of Allah. Yes. And you try to disconnect someone from him. So it means that you put him in the mouth of Satan. You put him in the mouth of disconnecting from a practical alim, as mean his disciples or his followers. You are actually, you don't know. But the ultimate result will be one and the same. Just to think about the ultimate result. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us. Professor is not here. Okay. So now they were making an objection that maybe Muhammad is telling certain lies also. So Allah said, in 40 years amongst you, when he was not receiving any message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, did you people ever knew about him that he told a lie in 40 years only once? Nobody was there who can say, yes, in 40 years only once he lied. No, they used to call him as-sadiqul amin. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, what's wrong with you? Now we are making this type of objection.
إِنَّ هَذِهِ تَذْكِرَةٌ. Verily this surah is tazkira, a reminder.
an admonition, a sincere advice, etiquette.
فَمَنْ شَاءَ اتَّخَذَ سُهُوسُ اِوَرْوِلْزُ اتَّخَذَ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي سَبِيلًا Let him take a path towards his Lord. وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ But you cannot will إِلَّا أَنْ يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ
Unless Allah wills that. So we talked about خلق, ابداع and تدبير. That this worldly system is running based on the tadbir of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the planning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not according to our planning. Our planning, it becomes successful when that coincided with the planning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or with the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If the case is other way around, then Allah's planning prevails and succeeds, and our plan, that's in vain. That's what we talked about. But as a Muslim, we are bound to do our own planning, number one. And number two, to obey Sharia. To obey Sharia. And to believe in the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are three things. Got it? So we are bound, number one, to do our own planning. Number two, to obey Sharia. Our planning may not be against Sharia, because that is not allowed then. And number three, to believe in the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that result will come according to the decree already been given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Got it? So there are three things. Obedience of Sharia, number one. Number two, our own planning in this worldly system. And number three, belief in Taqdeer. These are three things. Belief in what? In Taqdeer. In predestiny. Or pre-ordained divine law. Pre-P-R-E. Dash ordained divine law. That's how the Iman is. There is no contradiction. You know what I'm saying? And we say in Iman Mufassal, Amantu billah wa malaikatihi wa kutubihi wa rusuli wa liyumila wa al-qadri khairihi wa sharrihi min Allah ta'ala. That I believed in qadr, in preordained divine law, in predestiny, that everything is already been decreed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Got it? Got or not it? But it doesn't mean that we will sit like this waiting for the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That already decree has been done. Let the decree comes down. That against Sharia. Because in this worldly system, you are bound, number one, to obey Sharia, number two, to do your own planning. To obey Sharia, number two, to do your own planning. Now that is the third thing. That the result will come according to the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes? Got it? And that's why we say that Islam, insan, human being, insan. Insan or human being, he is subject to taqdeer and preordained divine law. He is subject to preordained divine law. So to that extent, he has no free will. But he is bound to obey Sharia. So to that extent, he has a free will. He has a free will. There are two groups. One is called Qadariya. And the other one is called Jabariya. Qadariya. Qadariya. And the other one is called Jabariya. And both of them have gone far astray of the true path. These people are on one extreme, this one is on the other extreme. They both are opposites and opponents to each other. Jabariya are those who do not believe in any preordained divine law. They say that this is human who makes his destiny. This is human who makes his destiny. That is wrong. And Jabariya, they are their opponents. They believe that human does not have any free will. Whatever he is doing, he is controlled by remote. That is wrong as well. Then we are just like dolls or toys. No, we are human. And we are human being. So the true faith is in between these two. The true faith is in this between the two. And the best example was given by Sayyidina Ali radiyallahu ta'ala an. When someone came to him, yes, because these people, Qadariya, they say that insan or human, he is Mukhtar. He is Mukhtar. Mukhtar means having a perfect will and perfect authority to achieve any goal. To achieve any goal. That's what Qadariya said. If it would have been the case, then all those who studied with Bill Gates, they should have achieved the same destiny. Yes? Some of them are, most of them, they were much more intelligent than who? Than Bill Gates. Got it? And Jabariya, they say that human is a majboor, having no will and no authority. Having no will and no authority. So if this is the case, so how can we make him subject to the rules of Allah? How could he would be punished on the day of judgment or would be rewarded? Because he has never done anything with his free will. You know what I'm saying? And if it would have been the case, so where Allah stands then? Yes, what's the duty of Allah? What Allah is doing now? You know what I'm saying? So Sayyidina Ali, somebody came to him, Brother Parvez. So somebody came to Sayyidina Ali, radiyallahu ta'ala an, and he said that we are Mukhtar or we are Majboor. We as human, we are what? Mukhtar, M-U-K-H-T-A-R. Or Majboor, M-A-J-B-U-R. We are Mukhtar, yani we can do anything. Allah has nothing to do with our doings. 100% free will. Or 100% power and authority. 100% control. Or we are Majboor, having no authority, no control and no any will. So Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu told him in between these two. What? So the guy, he said, I couldn't understand in between the two. So Ali further explained, something you can do with your free will, while some other you cannot do. Something you can do with your free will, but something else you cannot do. So he said, how? So Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala told him, stand up. So he stood up. So Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala, he ordered him, raise your right foot and right leg. He did it. He said, don't put it on the ground and raise the other one. Don't put it on the ground and raise the other one. Anybody can do that? He said, I understood now.
Inna hadhi tazkira, indeed this surah is tazkira. Inna hadhi tazkira, indeed this surah is an admonition. Faman sha'a, so whosoever wills. Ittakhadha, he may take ila rabbi toward his last sabil and depart and way. وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ and your people cannot will إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ unless Allah wills the same. إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ indeed Allah is عَلِيمًا حَكِيمًا all-knowing and all-wise. يدخلوا من يشاء ويل ادمت تو از ما يدخلوا من يشاء ويل ادمت هم هي ويل في رحمته انتو هيز مرسي والظالمين اند راوند اس اعد لهم عذابا اليما هي هيز prepared for round doors a painful torment.
So the brief summary of Surah Al-Ata or Surah Al-Insan,
we have created human and we have given him such a nature that he can do good and evil, but the evil doers, they will have the punishment, and the good doers, they will have the favors. We have sent you this Quran. Be committed to your message. Never compromise. Be committed to worship, to strengthen your belief furthermore. People are in love with this world. They do not think of the hereafter. And this surah is a perfect admonition.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاه والسلام على رسول محمد وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين اللهم ربنا حنا بالقران من رزقنا بالقران ما نسينا وعلمنا من ما جعل الله صلاه وتعالى على الليل وعلى النهار فالله خير الحافظ.